What screen?
Claire?
You see it, don't you?
Call the number on the screen, they'll shoot one right out to you.
It's Tad, this one?
All right, I'll call the number.
This is CNN.
Word of a tremendous return in sports is in the air tonight. Predicting a deadly disease years before it strikes, would you want to know? And Fashion Week in New York, what you could be wearing next season. The news begins now. Tonight, will Air Jordan fly again? We've just received our strongest indication yet. Exploiting young lives. It may be going on in your neighborhood.
It's almost an epidemic. About 110, 120 girls in the last 2.5 years.
From the cutting edge of medicine, predicting rather than merely diagnosing Alzheimer's.
There are changes in the brain in normal people that will predict a worsening of their memory performance.
And it's time to look out to sea and wonder, what if the big one hits this year?
You ever heard the devil breathing down your neck? You have a devil here.
It's 10 o'clock on the West Coast, 1 o'clock on the East, 11 and 12 in the Heartland. This is CNN Tonight. From the CNN Center in Atlanta, Catherine Calloway.
Good evening, everyone. We begin tonight with a new beginning. For Michael Jordan, CNN Sports Illustrated's Marty Burns has confirmed that Air Jordan plans to return to the NBA this season. 38-year-old Jordan will play for the Washington Wizards and is expected to make the formal announcement in the next 10 days. Jordan is an executive with the Wizards and will have to sell his financial stake in the company to return to pro ball. He said he's coming back, quote, for the love of the game, nothing else. Jordan's return will be one of the most anticipated returns in sports history. CNN Sports Illustrated, Tom Rinaldi with more.
Jordan, open, Chicago with the lead. That may have been the last shot Michael Jordan will ever take in the NBA. If that's the last image of Michael Jordan, how magnificent is it?
It is not the critic who counts. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, who knows his place shall never be with those timid and cold souls who know neither victory nor defeat. Teddy Roosevelt, who wrote those words, never met Michael Jordan. But the words still seem to mark Jordan's mission. Yes, there's a lot to lose when you are already a statue, but Michael Jordan refuses to rust.
Done a half dozen encores, brought the house down, and now after the curtain apparently fell for the final time, he's rushing back into the lobby, pulling the patrons back into the theater, going, wait, one more thing. It just doesn't feel right.
He'll still be a very fine basketball player, but I doubt very seriously that he'll ever be able to live up to what he was doing at the time when he finished, particularly that storybook finish with that last shot.
Do I want him to do it? No. Because I would never want him to mess with the legacy, the things that made him be the best that's ever played. I would never want that to, him to, anything to go wrong.
13 seasons in Chicago, 10 scoring titles, 5 MVPs. He won a championship in each of his last 6 full seasons. The perfect ending. So why do it? Why risk failure? Why endanger a legacy and a comeback? Perhaps to serve the very same drive and desire that forged the greatest career in NBA history. He left the game, but did the game and its drive and desire leave him?
You say he's 39 years old and he can't come back and do what he's done all through his career. I won't be the one to say that, you know? I mean, he knows what he has inside of him. And he has one of the biggest hearts that ever stepped out on the dance floor.
If Mike wants to come back, God bless him. I mean, you know, I know he's going to work extremely hard to get himself in shape and in playing shape to compete and to be the best. So if he wants to come back, God bless him. I wish him the best.
In sports, career postscripts rarely read well. We see Willie Mays as a Met, Joe Namath as a Ram, John Unitas as a Charger. We shake our heads trying to clear the picture. But we also see Lance Armstrong in the Tour de France, or Mario Lemieux on the ice, igniting their worlds and shining a glare on their sports all over again.
I think the main thing is to prepare yourself physically, first of all, and mentally, that you're going to have some ups and downs during your comeback. You're not always going to feel 100%, and that's the main thing if you miss 2 or 3 years.
Since retiring, Michael Jordan didn't leave the arena, literally. He could be spotted on occasion in the ozone of an owner's box, peering down from on high in tie and cufflinks. Perhaps he's trying to clear that picture. Perhaps he still has a need for victory again, at the immediate risk of defeat. In Los Angeles, I'm Tom Rinaldi.
And for more on Michael Jordan's return to the NBA and highlights of his career, you can click on to CNN.com. The AOL keyword is CNN. A warning tonight from experts that say that child sexual exploitation is on the rise in the U.S. A new study estimates as many as 400,000 children are victims of crimes that range from sexual abuse to prostitution and pornography. Here is CNN's Rusty Dornan with the story of one young woman caught up in the cycle of exploitation.
Oakland police close in on a pimp, a man suspected of prostituting 14-year-old girls.
Oakland police, search warrant! Show me your hands, everybody hands up!
The suspect wasn't home. Oakland police say they don't need a new study to know that child prostitution is rampant. The proof walks the streets.
It's almost an epidemic. We have about 110, 120 girls in the last 2.5 years that we've interviewed and identified as being child prostitutes.
75% of child prostitutes in the U.S. come from working or middle-class families, according to the new study funded in part by the Justice Department. This 17-year-old girl knows. She's from a well-educated family in Oakland, California. She says her boyfriend talked her into doing the unthinkable, a boyfriend of which she is now so frightened that both she and her mother don't want their faces shown for the interview.
I was 16 when I got involved in prostitution. A boyfriend of mine made slight comments of how beautiful I was, how much money guys would pay to be with me, how I could make more money than the next female, and I was really intrigued by that. At the beginning, it's always about love. It's always about, I love you, so I'm going to do this for you. I'm going to sell my body. I'm going to sell drugs. I'm going to, you know, do whatever you ask me to do for love.
She believed all the myths about prostitutes until it happened to her.
It was something that only people that were lowlifes and females that had been raped or in and out of jail did. And then 3 or 4 years later, I was doing it. And it was sort of like I was still better than them because I came from a better family and I had more of a chance of making more money.
Her mother found out a year later. She was dumbfounded.
All of these girls that were at my house baking cookies, you know, 15, 20 of them that I know of, are out there selling their bodies. And their parents don't have a clue until I call them. And it's more serious than you know. And you don't see it coming.
She took her daughter here, a recovery program for prostitutes in San Francisco called the SAGE Project. Former child prostitute director Norma Hodeling says parents need to pimp-proof their children.
Become informed on the recruitment tactics of pimps and recruiters because they are at your children's parties, they are at the malls, they are hanging around the schools, they are the guys that the girls are becoming involved with.
Hodeling says the best way to keep your kids off the streets is to spend a lot of time communicating with them at home. Rusty Dornan, CNN, San Francisco.
The West Nile virus may be in the U.S. to stay. Health officials say that the mosquito-borne virus is making a significant expansion into the South and Midwest. They predict it could reach California in just months. One official says that we can no longer hope to eradicate it, only control it. Well, the effects of Alzheimer's disease are crippling and deadly, and detecting it before it strikes is almost impossible. But researchers around the country are meeting that challenge head on. CNN medical correspondent Rhonda Rowland with more.
Yvonne Muller and dozens of other young, healthy volunteers have agreed to undergo brain scans every year for the rest of their lives to help scientists determine when Alzheimer's begins to set in.
This study is designed to look at the earliest features
in the brain that predict some of the earliest changes in behavior that are consistent with an Alzheimer's disease path.
But already, Dr. Moni De Leon says his team has found an important clue by using the PET scan, a clue that could make it possible to predict whether a healthy elderly person is going to develop a precursor to Alzheimer's, known as mild cognitive impairment.
This study is the first study ever to show that there are changes in the brain in normal people that will predict a worsening of their memory performance.
The change? A dwindling of glucose metabolism in a small part of the brain known to be a memory center. Glucose is fuel to the brain, fuel to our thoughts.
Results show that we can make predictions among normal people as to who is going to develop memory impairment. It does not tell us at this point whether those memory impairments are caused by Alzheimer's.
Researchers say this latest finding is another step towards an early diagnostic tool. They already know a part of the brain called the hippocampus shrinks in Alzheimer's patients.
Here are the areas of the brain that are often affected by Alzheimer's early on.
Last year, UCLA researchers found that in patients with a known genetic risk for Alzheimer's, the PET scan could pick up brain changes before Alzheimer's symptoms appeared.
What we found that was very striking was that in the people who had the genetic risk for Alzheimer's disease, they all had a significant decline in areas of the brain that ultimately are affected by Alzheimer's disease.
By finding the disease early, before discernible memory loss sets in, researchers predict they'll be able to stop the disease in its tracks with effective drugs or perhaps even a vaccine. But so far, they have neither in hand. Rhonda Rowland, CNN, Atlanta.
Well, today a Senate committee began looking into claims that senior citizens are being swindled by companies selling dietary supplements and promising a fountain of youth. Lawmakers heard testimony from a former top executive of one company who says that its advertisements promising miracle cures are laden with lies and deception. He says the company's profiting to the tune of $200 million a year. A grand jury in Jacksonville, Florida has indicted an employee of a marketing company and 20 others in that alleged scheme to steal McDonald's contest prizes. Prosecutors say that Jerome Jacobson withheld winning game pieces from the McDonald's Monopoly contest and conspired with others to redeem them. Well, we've just reached the peak of the hurricane season. CNN will be focusing on hurricanes all this week. Tonight, we look at living along the Atlantic coast and why experts say that the danger's growing. Plus, low riders and high fashion merge on a New York catwalk. Our Jeannie Moats was in the middle. Oops. All that ahead, but first, other stories making news on the road.
Beer you got? A food?
Anything else?
Haydn's Cello Concerto in C major.
Which performance? Rorsky? Piatti?
Or Chin?
How's that possible?
Our jukebox is every performance by every artist of every piece of music ever recorded.
This is the technology that makes it happen. This is Riding the Light. Quest.
They're coming through town. Williams volunteers from all over the country. Riding along pipeline routes, raising money for the United Way. Last year, $16 million. This year, even more. Please support your local United Way with a contribution that stays in your community.
We don't think of it as charity. We think of it as our investment in a better world.
He flew to 17 cities in 3 weeks. Flew to the top of the ladder. Flew the red eye to catch his son's game. Who's he sleeping with? Weston. Where he touches down in the new heavenly bed. Weston. Who are you sleeping with?
take this.
What?
It's me, Roger.
Roger?
I know. He came back as a monkey. Come back next Tuesday. I make a killing on Tuesdays. And next time, wear that red dress I like.
How will you support your family after you pass away? Conseco's life insurance policies can give your loved ones a regular monthly paycheck. Conseco, step up.
It's the small screen's biggest night. Join Lauren Sidney and Bill Tush for coverage of the Primetime Emmy Awards, including red carpet arrivals, backstage interviews, and a complete wrap-up of all the night's winners. Log on to cnn.com/showbiz for Emmy news and much more. Showbiz Today reports coverage of the Primetime Emmy Awards begins September 13th on CNN. Brought to you by the HP PhotoSmart Digital Camera. How will you use it?
Packing 100-mile-per-hour winds, but losing some steam, forecasters say that Hurricane Erin is about 500 miles south of Nova Scotia tonight. Now, Erin is the first hurricane of the Atlantic season, narrowly missing Bermuda yesterday. Its threat comes at the historical peak of hurricane season. CNN's John Zarella will be looking at hurricanes all this week. And first tonight, the looming danger to the Atlantic coast.
Oh, heads up. Oh.
When the big one is bearing down on you.
This is going to be one of the big natural disasters in our nation's history.
What will you do? If you stay to ride out the storm, will you live to cry about it?
Oh, help me.
Do you have any idea the terror you will experience?
You ever heard the devil breathing down your neck? We have the devil here.
And the devil is coming again. Perhaps sooner than you think.
I think we will see a $50 billion hurricane in the next 10, 20 years. That's almost without a doubt.
The reason? During the past 50 years, the population living on or near the coast from Maine to Texas has nearly doubled to 83 million people. Coastal development has boomed. In 20 years, property value has increased sixfold to more than $6 trillion. And during the same period of exploding growth, major hurricanes rarely hit the U.S.
I think this is a powder keg waiting to go off.
Now, after 30 years of relative quiet in the tropics, scientists say the climate has cycled back to an era of more frequent, powerful hurricanes. And in the U.S., at least 85% of the people living in harm's way have never experienced a major hurricane.
These people do not really know what a major hurricane can do, and that really concerns me.
Max Mayfield directs the National Hurricane Center in Miami.
That's why we were agonizing here.
Mayfield oversees a team of forecasters. The tools of their trade, orbiting satellites, hurricane hunter aircraft, computer models.
Guidance shall track in all directions.
Forecasters can track a storm across the ocean. They can tell when it becomes a hurricane.
But two of the most critical questions, questions that may mean the difference between saving thousands of lives or losing them, they simply can't answer with confidence. Where exactly is the hurricane going, and how powerful will it be when it gets there?
Because of this uncertainty, the forecasters worry.
But it's moving very slowly.
Worry they will be caught off guard.
The tropical storm warning for Belize.
Ambushed.
That's definitely becoming much better organized.
As they were last year, when Hurricane Keith, in a mere 12 hours, morphed from a weak hurricane to a brute killer as it slammed into Belize in Central America.
If that had happened anywhere along the United States coastline, it would have been a disaster.
The ingredients are all there.
People ignoring the evacuation order, the cry wolf syndrome, insufficient transportation network, shelter deficit, you name it. These things are all compounding when you put that on top of this population explosion in the coastal areas. We're building a case for catastrophe, no question about it.
John Zarella, CNN, Miami.
Coming up tomorrow, a look at evacuations and how they can be part of the problem instead part of the solution. Be sure and tune in to CNN Presents Sunday night for hurricanes when the big one hits. That's at 10 p.m. Eastern Time, 7 Pacific. Well, this is also the week when fashion designers reveal their looks for spring.
It's another eye-popping fashion week, and you don't have to be a happy camper to flock to these tents.
Jeannie Most on what's in, what's out, and what's odd in fashion. But first, our Moneyline update.
I'm Jan Hopkins with this Moneyline update. A disheartening session after Friday's brutal sell-off, the Dow today barely budged, down less than a point to end at 96.05. The Nasdaq gained, but the rally was less than inspiring. The index rose 7 points to close at 1695. In economic news, consumer credit virtually unchanged in July. Economists expected an increase. That stokes fears that consumers are pulling back on spending. Watch Lou Dobbs Moneyline at 6 p.m. and 11:30 p.m. Eastern weeknights on CNN.
Moneyline Update is brought to you by Bank of America. Make banking work as never before. Why not? Bank of America. Grow.
Being first is never easy. Will I make it? Will I be laughed at? Will it be worth it?
Makes you happy? Post your resume now. Monster.com.
You the monster.
Hi, Fred. Looks like IT will be jumping through hoops again today.
Fred, I sent out an email about the email being down.
I opened that virus just like you told us not to.
Hi, Fred. That looks like another all-nighter. Sorry.
At CDW, we understand what it can be like in IT. That's why you get computing solutions from your highly trained account manager and services designed to make your day a little easier.
What's wrong, Fred? We're only asking the impossible.
CDW, computing solutions built for business.
The energy industry. What it takes to succeed has changed. Sure, it takes a level head and foresight. But should challenges arise, success will also require a company that's able to take care of business. Introducing Progress Energy. We're stable, but never standing still.
With Post-it pop-up notes and the handy dispenser, you always know where your notes are. So, you won't go nuts looking for nuts. And Post-it pop-up dispensers also come in these cool colors.
For Miss America 2002. They arrived in Atlantic City, New Jersey today. That pageant is next Saturday. This year, it includes a quiz on current events, history, and government. Should be interesting. Well, it's Fashion Week in New York City, and that means some of the most unusual clothes that you'll ever see. CNN's Jeannie Most found out some of the oddest outfits are not even on the catwalk. Here she is, making the most of it.
It's another eye-popping fashion week, and you don't have to be a happy camper to flock to these tents.
Flawless. Flawless.
Well, maybe not flawless. It's not just the models who have their eyebrows done.
Your eyebrows are mesmerizing in this color.
Yeah, well, I'm playing for the fashion crowd.
Who isn't? You can bet almost everyone who comes to the shows thinks long and hard about what to wear.
All stuff from the 50s, including the glasses.
And though the most unusual outfits are reserved for the runway, some looks make you want to run away.
Whoa.
He wouldn't talk, but young designers hoping to make it big are only too happy to say a few words.
The name of the line is called Chan Paul. Okay, in one word. And my name is Paul Chan.
Paul Chan says Chan Paul looks good as a logo. Entrance to the shows is by invitation only.
I didn't get in.
But Kim Cattrall did. The actress from Sex and the City was all smiles at the Patricia Field show. Pat Field is the stylist for Sex and the City, so maybe someday we'll see Cattrall's character in one-legged trousers with leg irons. We understand why the editor of Vogue attends the shows, but an editor from National Geographic? The magazine has done a fashion book.
This is fashion around the world and fashion through times.
Read about outfits made of reeds, or South Pacific Islanders wearing fish, or this towering turban from Burkina Faso. A former UN diplomat wears different outfits with the same theme throughout Fashion Week. Zebras one day, stripes the next.
I have a veritable zoo in my closet. You name it, I have it.
In one sense, fashion has reached new lows.
Yeah, they're Brazilian. It's like the latest trend. I've got lower ones, but I didn't want to
really?
Scare. I didn't want to scare the New Yorker.
I mean, these are really low jeans.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you have to practically shave.
Yeah.
You have to shave?
Yeah.
But not the guy in the low riders with the lace-up fly.
No, I don't have that hairy problem.
The laces go on the shoes, not on the crotch.
You're never too young to be fashionable. Let's see whose shorts you got on. Oh, Ralph Lauren. Nice. Very nice. Some guys like to let the band of their underwear show.
That's his own little fashion trend because it's his diaper. It's not underwear.
Lo and behold. Jeannie Mo, CNN, New York.
And that's it for CNN Tonight. We do want to hear from you. We want to know what you think about tonight's news. Here's the address. Tell Catherine at CNN.com. Greenfield at Large is next. We hope you'll join us again tomorrow night. Good night, everyone.
As a National Car Rental Emerald Club member, you can bypass the counter, which saves time. Take the car of your choice, which saves time. And when Emerald Club members return their car, National will fill it up at gas station prices, which saves money and time. If we can give you 43 more minutes to enjoy Disney's newest theme park, Disney's California Adventure, then we've done our job. 43 minutes. How will you spend it? The Emerald Club from National.
You can go your own way.
The official car rental company of Disney's California Adventure in California.
Buying or selling a home? REMAX agents lighten that load. Averaging more than 13 years' experience, they work the kind of practical magic that sets you free. REMAX.
Yes.
What do you say to investors who are a little frightened of the current market?
Is this a good time to get out?
What if the downtrend continues?
First, just relax. When markets are down, we all get fearful about it. Investing is about the long term.
If you have a few bonds in your account, a little bit of cash, a little bit of stock, you can weather almost any kind of a market.
To learn more, call 1-800-3-SCHWAB today to sign up for our complimentary workshop, Navigating Today's Market.
Unexpected guests say the most unpredictable things on Greenfield at Large next. Then join the team of Sports Tonight, followed by Lou Dobbs Moneyline on CNN.
But I will be watching you.
You get a load of this.
Looks good.
That's just for starters. So much to watch, so little time. HBO, all these channels. Extensive, not expensive. Get it with a click or a call. HBO, just $12.99 a month on Dish Network. Go for it.
It wasn't only a career change, it was a change in our lifestyle.
I'm really proud of her. She's really cool.
She brings a different point of view. I think she'll get ahead very fast.
Thanks to my education, my family and I feel much more secure.
ITT Technical Institute, education for the future. To find out more, call 1-800-741-5232. That's 1-800-741-5232.
This is CNN.